Bonjour.
Здравейте.
And
welcome.
Hi.
Hello.
Yeah, how's it going?
Today is the Bulgarian national holiday, so naturally we're going to do something special linked to Bulgarian. Mm-hmm. Actually, when I said this to Alex, he seemed so excited about it. It got me really happy. And then I realized that he thought I was talking about food. But anyway, let's try to make this fun. Mm. I chose one grammatical point that I think is really cool. I'll just note that it is not a Bulgarian thing only. It is a general Slavic thing. Mm. So if you know a language like Russian, then this will definitely sound familiar. So I'm going to talk about reflexive pronouns. Mm-hmm. Reflexive means that the subject and the object of the sentence are one and the same. Mm. And in Bulgarian we say vzvraten, which gives the idea of something coming back, of circular motion. Mm. Sometimes, what I really like about the reflexive pronouns in Bulgarian is that they can resolve ambiguity the way it cannot be resolved in French or English. I'll show you what I mean.
Yeah.
For example, he used his telephone. Mm-hmm. Or il a utilisé son téléphone. Mm. You cannot tell if he used his own telephone or someone else's telephone, right?
I suppose, yeah.
Yeah, it could be like George used Peter's telephone. It will still be he used his telephone. Mm. Or it could be George used George's telephone. Mm. But we will say той използва телефона си, meaning his own, as opposed to той използва телефона му, another person's.
Oh yeah, okay, I see.
I will talk about the reflexive personal pronouns and the reflexive, the others, possessive pronouns. So the personal pronouns are like I, you, but also me, you know, him, her. You have this these different types of personal pronouns in French too, you know. And the difference between them, it's a very strange way to think about it, but it's a question of case.
Yeah.
You know, as you probably know, there is no case system in English or French or even Bulgarian as a Slavic language. It's known for not having one.
Yeah.
Yet the different personal pronouns can be explained in terms of case. For example, we got, you know, something like I love you. Je t'aime, j'aime toi. Mm-hmm. Here,
j'aime toi.
Okay, I'm just trying to explain what it means, right? So toi and tu means that you're the direct object, right?
Yeah.
And this is called accusative case. Mm-hmm. So these would be personal pronouns in the accusative case.
Yeah.
And then we have the dative, which refers to the indirect object.
Yeah.
For example, I say to you. Je dis quelque chose à toi. Mm. It is only this to or à that makes the difference in English and French. In Bulgarian, for example, we have te for the accusative and ti for the dative. Обичам те, казвам ти. These are both short forms. Обичам те, обичам теб. I love you. But казвам ти, казвам на теб. I say to you. And what I want to talk about is the reflexive forms, which are se and si, and the full version sebe si, or na sebe si if it's dative.
Yeah.
For example, we can have udarih se, I hit myself.
Yeah.
Or udarih sebe si, but of course no one would use the full version in many cases. But also kupih si, kupih na sebe si. I bought for myself.
Yeah.
Yes. And now the reflexive possessive pronouns. You know, the possessive pronouns are the ones that show possession, like my, your. Here we have no cases. We have no different forms dependent on the role in the sentence. And in Bulgarian, for the reflexive ones again, we do not have the cases we had in the case of personal pronouns, but we also do not have, you know, we don't have the person like with sebesi. Whether it's us, it's still sebesi.
Yeah.
You know, like myself, moi-même, we don't have any toi-même, yourself. It's always sebesi. It's always the same. The same goes for the possessive pronouns.
Yeah.
You can show our guest here.
Ah, we have a special guest, yeah.
Yeah, Gato the cat.
Which is a diva, she doesn't want to be shown. So, yeah.
Yes, so with the reflexive possessive pronouns, they concord with what follows. For example, my something, it concords in number and gender with the thing that is mine.
Yeah.
So we have svoja, svojata, svojto, svojte. These are the forms with definite articles.
Yeah.
And we have si, which is the short form, which doesn't change at all. It's always the same. Stupich si kraka, I broke my leg.
Yeah.
Stupi si kraka, you broke your leg.
Yeah.
Your own leg.
Yeah.
Toj si izmi racete, he washed his own hands. He washed his hands. Also, let's say, toj mi dade ključa na svojata kola. He gave me the key to his car, his own car. If we say ključa na negovata kola, it could be that he gave the key to someone else's car, like I said in the beginning, which is a really cool feature. Now, in order to further show this, can you read this first exercise, basically? Yeah. Pravilno ili grešno, right or wrong?
I knew it would end up to this.
Of course you did, you printed it.
So, pravilno ili grešno. The expression gordeja se vstep makes use of the reflexive pronouns se.
You know, gordeja se vstep means I'm proud of you, right?
Yeah, another one. Gordeja se vstep. The expression TC.
No, please answer it first.
Ah, should I?
Is it right or wrong that the expression gordeja se vstep makes use of the reflexive pronoun se? Gordeja se.
Like I am proud of, isn't it? So gordeja se vstep. I would tend to say no, but I wouldn't wouldn't be quite.
I'll tell you a way to check that. Can we exchange with sebesi? Gordeja sebesi step?
Yeah, it doesn't.
No,
work.
Absolutely not. It's just the way the verb is.
That's a cool technique, actually. I should. Should write that down afterwards.
Yes, very often you just replace a short form with with the long one.
Light intermission to someone that wants to go out.
It's a cat.
Yeah.
Okay, so if we cannot exchange se with sebesi and si with na sebesi, then it is not the reflexive pronoun. Next.
Yeah. Actually, it's really fun that I just felt it wasn't that, but
that's what I do most of the time.
I absolutely cannot put into words, so
yeah.
Actually, I'm probably not the right type to learn several languages. The expression TC zgotfish, TC zgotfil, is that okay?
Yep, you have cooked.
Makes use of the reflexing pronoun C, TC gotfil. No. Asem TC.
The verb to be, yes. Yep. This is a past tense in which we use the verb to be. Okay, next one, look. Imagine that I want to say that you are going to the restaurant with Aurélie, which is...
My sister.
His sister. Would it be correct if I were to say Alex otiva na ресторант с сестра му?
Sestra si.
Yeah! Then there'll be someone else's sister, not
yeah.
yours.
Ah, I see. Oh, okay, get that.
That's cool.
Ah, very interesting. Actually, I'm discovering things.
That's the idea. Mm. Okay, now we have a correct the mistakes thing.
Alright, so... Поправи грешките.
Поправи is the imperative, not поправи, which means he fixed, you fixed. Anyway.
Ако има такива. Обичам да играя с своето си куче. Обичам да играя с своето си куче. Своето си.
Yep.
Твоя?
No, it's my own dog, so it has to be reflexive. But you cannot use the short and long forms together. You have to pick one. Своето куче, кучето си.
Кучето си.
Not своето си куче.
Кучето си.
Something our son does all the time. He repeats stuff like that all the time. All
right.
Saying the same thing in the same sentence twice.
Fair. Излязох да на пазарувам дрехи на за мен.
I went shopping for clothes.
It sounds right to me.
За себе си.
За себе си.
For myself.
Ah.
Right, not за, for me, but for myself.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Mm. Not за мен, but...
За себе си.
За себе си, okay. Казах на своя родители, че ще... Very difficult to say. Че ще закъснея.
Mm-hmm. I told my parents that I would be late, but please be very careful with this word. I didn't really hear you pronounce it.
Своите. Своите.
Is that all right? You think that's all
right? Sounds wrong to me, but...
Yes, and I'll tell you why. This might be complicated because we had the I kratko.
Yeah.
We don't need the kratko here. It sounds a bit like it. That would be an equivalent, rough equivalent of Y in English as opposed to I.
Yeah.
But when we have plural involved, we don't use I kratko. We use the regular I. Svoite roditeli.
Yeah.
Not svoite. It sounds like it, but it's not
svoite.
It.
Okay. Ти помагаш на своят приятел. Домашното му.
Mm-hmm. You're helping your friend with his homework.
Домашното му. Is that okay?
Yeah, his homework. You know, that's the definite article. The домашното.
Homework. Домашното. Yeah, okay. So yeah, reflexive.
That's not linked to being reflexive.
It's not linked. Sorry. what's своя приятел?
Mm-hmm. Your own friend, is there anything wrong here? We could have svoja or svojat, right? In this case, which one do we need? This is the...
It's... I never know, is it...
Who is the friend performing the action?
No,
so no. We don't put the full definite article, it should be svoja.
Svoja, okay. Imam problem s projektami. Projektami.
Projekta.
Projektami.
Projektami.
Sounds right to me, but...
That's right.
Sounds right to me.
You can, I'm pretty sure you can also use C and say Sprojekta si, because it's your own project. But it is... Sprojekta si. I think both are fine. Yes. Very often, if there is no ambiguity, you can use them the reflexive and the non-reflexive interchangeably.
All right.
What's wrong with me? I made it up and then I'm not sure if it's wrong or right. I don't know what was in my head when I went
to Interesting. Well, you know, you've lived in France for what, like a whole year now. So when you cut off. Anyways, расскажи мне за твоята ваканция. Твоята.
It's linked to reflexive, right? Mm. Is it okay to say твоята, or would it have to be своята ваканция?
It's 50-50. It's своята ваканция.
Both are okay. Both are no okay. Ambiguity whatsoever. Mm. If it was his or her, it would be ambiguous. Him with his something, yeah. Her with hers, it with its, it would be ambiguous. In this case, it is not ambiguous.
I see.
Alright, so enough grammar.
Mm.
Now we're going to do a bit of reading.
So yeah, I'll practice my elementary school skills.
It's a complex language, so good luck with that. But I just want to say, if you know one Bulgarian author, it would have to be Ivan Vazov. He's really the most famous one. And this is one of his rare comedies. Can you read it? It has lots of very nice letters.
Chichovtsi.
Chichovtsi. Can you tell what that means?
Chicho is like... uncle, right?
Yes.
And it's actually uncle on your father's side.
That's
otherwise, if it's on your mother's
right.
side, it's vujicho.
That's perfectly right. But
yeah.
Do you think it really talks of many, many, many uncles from your brother's side? Or do you think it means
something else? Doesn't it mean like old man?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Just old man.
Mm.
Alright, so many chapters here start with a description of a particular character.
Yeah.
So we'll read one of these. It includes a bit of French fashion, American fashion, so this is the one I picked.
Mm.
Please read the first paragraph for me and then give me this one.
Yeah. Do I read the paragraph's title? Well, the whole...
Okay. It starts with the title, so it's all the same.
Fair
you know?
Enough. So, Haji Smyon?
Smyon.
Smyon. Haji Smyon. Беше се обляк в френските си дрехи и пиеше спокойно цигарото. Нямаше нищо по-добро душно от физиономията на Хаджи Смиона.
It is a case. A case where a little bit of
the Глава дългнеста.
But it becomes дългнеста. It's a moving
Дългнеста.
Дългнеста.
Дългнеста. Lovely. И сплескана. It makes me think of плескавица.
That's where it comes from. It means,
Exactly. So that's one. Yeah. На ушите, лице сухичко. Плескавица is like something like ground beef. Like,
it is.
Yeah.
But it's I think it's Serbian.
Yeah, it is. Like apparently. Yeah. But Bulgarians love it. Mershavichko.
Mršavičko.
By the way, I always mix up the L sound. I tend to, in my head, I link it more to the E, you know, like the French E, which is obviously a mistake. Like, if anything, you link it to the A sound, like A sound. So, yeah. Well done, me. I bezobidno.
Harmless.
Yeah. Поглед безстрастен, безстрастен, глуповът и вечно усмихнат. Хаджи Смьон имаше около 45 години.
You know, normally we don't say to have with the age. We absolutely don't do that, but apparently
Yeah, it was it. Once that's done. Interesting. Yeah, you never said it. Mm-hmm. Носеше шаячни възкъсички панталони до колене, френска риза. Suppose it's like the very Buffon thing, I suppose.
Maybe.
Без вратов. Връзка. А воз вратовска.
Тайска.
А, окей. Плитки кареври. Дълбок голям фес. А, that's the...
The hat.
Yeah, the hat. Който му падаше до веждите. И сиво шая чево
Сетре.
Сетре is a jacket. Сетре. Сетре. Yeah. You see again, like I'm not reading the F properly. Сетре на което дясната половина на гърба имаше възчерен свят.
Цвят.
Yeah, I was his.
Not world, yeah. Color.
Had a world. Цвят. 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 А лявата по Белезняв. Която странност обаче Хаджи Смион обясняваше по твърде пост начин на уния, който го питаха за нея. I do hope Stefan's reading better than me.
Yes.
Yeah, good.
По модата в Америка. Американски, казваше той. Хаджи Смион казваше това без най-малката цел да излъже. Той го казваше естествено и с пълно чисто сърдечие. Американско за него беше всичко, що се отличаваше с особено качество или с ексцентричност.
That hasn't changed much.
Не искаме да кажем, че Хаджи Смион не обичаше да лъже. Напротив. Но и лъжата му беше чисто сърдечна. И като честен човек, той пръв си повярваше. That's really cool, like, he was a very honest man. It's not that he didn't lie, on the contrary, but when he lied, him as an honest person was the first to believe himself.
That's good.
Но щом дойдеше работата до прение, изведнъж отстъпяше, защото Хаджи Смион естествено беше твърде миролюбив и никой не помни от как се е той завърнал от Молдовата. Живеенето му в Молдавия беше велика дата за него. Да се е карал с някого или поне да се е препирал, освен с Лилка Алтапармака, и то за един политически въпрос. Хаджи Смион беше страшен политик. Относително смъртта на Максимилиана в Мексико. Хаджи Смион поддържаше, че бил заклан от джелатин. Алтапармакът по един безобразен начин доказваше, че го били обесили на една черница. За да го обори, Хаджи Смион на посока каза, че няма черници в Америка. Това прение щеше да придобие още по-бурен характер, ако Иван Чойотата не беше донесъл от лавката си новоизлязлата картина, която представляваше застрелянето на Максимилиана. Препирнята изведнъж се прекрати и Хаджи Смион си излезе из кафенето, очуден от бикоглавството на Алтапармака, който без да е видял нещо, приказва, за което Иван Чойотата ги нарече и двамата добичета. Както и да е, това беше един случай, в който Хаджи Смион неблагоразумно се хвърли в неизвестностите на една словесна война. Затова той избягваше възраженията. Нито ги правеше, нито искаше да му ги правят. Това правило влезна в живота му и му стана привичка. Мисълта му машинално следеше мисълта на събеседника му във всичките й произволи. И когато Ненчо Орешков, съседът му, кажеше I'll let you read the dialogue. Do you want to actually like read it?
Yeah,
like,
that'd be cool.
Role playing. So we learned that he didn't like conflicts. He would really agree with people. Let's see how it went.
So, who do I read?
Do the first one. So right. You're not him, you're not Haji's Mion, you're his neighbor.
I got that. Haji, днес имаме ясно време. Той, той отговаряше.
Много ясно време, Ненчо.
Май каквото гледам и да облаци от Балкана. Хъм са дъждовим.
Дъждовни.
Дъждовни.
Дъждовни облаци идат, Ненчо.
Ще завали и ще побърка на Хармания.
Ще завали, Ненчо. Без друго ще завали. Хем, едър.
Господ зная, Господ зная пак, има вятър от запад. Да ще за разнесе дъжда. Кажеше Пенчо.
One of us will have to do it. Кажеше Ненчо, като изгледваше облаците. И аз това казвам, ще го разнесе Ненчо.
Ба, дъжд няма да има.
Свърши Ненчо, като се прозине и тръгне към Хармана. Нито капка, Ненчо, потвърдяваха Джи Смион и потегля към кафенето. Can you say what they were talking about?
It was about the weather. With like,
yes.
Was yeah, it's gonna be the biggest storm there ever was. But no, actually, it's not gonna rain.
Yeah,
and
the thing
before
is,
the weather was great, and like the Haji Smion. By the way, I think you should say what Haji stands for in Bulgaria.
Haji is a person who went to Jerusalem, or a family member went to Jerusalem.
Mm.
Yeah, but the thing is, the weather did not change.
Yeah.
It's just like his neighbor was, the weather is nice, right? Yeah, right, it's nice.
Yeah.
But actually, it's not nice. I think it's going to rain. Yeah, it's going to rain a lot.
Yeah.
No, actually, I think it's not. It's gonna stay dry. Yes, very dry. So practically showing how much he agrees with everything. Mm. It reminds me of Hamlet. There is a thing in Hamlet where, you know, Hamlet.
Not that I would know.
Hamlet is just sick of, you know, his servants just agreeing with everything he says. It was related to clouds too, or although quite different. It was like, yeah, look at this cloud. It looks so much like, I don't know, a sheep. Yeah, it does. It looks exactly like a sheep. Actually, no, I think it looks like a house. Yeah, exactly. It looks like 100% like a house.
I see, yeah.
So maybe that's it.
Yeah, okay, fair enough.
Thank you guys.
Yeah, well, thanks for making me think about Bulgarian, and I should practice.
Yes.
So yeah, happy 3rd of March. Честита
Честит 3 март, честит национален празник.
И точно така.
See you guys.
Bye.
Subscribe.
Yeah.